Welcome back. This is Master's Way video tutorials. And always don't forget, our motto is we are reaching the world with the beauty of mathematics. In fact, we started the whole journey from first order differential equation, and we are done with all the techniques for the first order differential equation. Is it about separable? Is it about homogeneous? Is it about exact? Or whatever, everything we are done with, and 8 applications. Now here we are, that is higher order linear equation. Higher order linear equations. But this is part one of the higher order linear differential equation. Alright, another part one or the first aspect, you'll be looking at the introduction part. Then after that, we move on to general theory of second order linear equations. Then we move on to linear differential operator. Then we'll be looking at homogeneous linear equations with constant coefficients. We'll be also looking at solution to homogeneous linear equation with constant coefficients. And lastly, we'll be looking at Cauchy-Euler equation. Cauchy-Euler equation. Trust me, it's going to be interesting for us all. Yes, I'm not so bad. It's going to be interesting for us all. So let's start with the introduction. So let's start with the introduction. Alright. So the study of the linear differential equation is of both theoretical and practical importance. Alright, very good. There are several applications of linear equation of order greater than one. Don't forget that all that we have been looking at in the first order linear differential equation, that is when we are dealing with order of one. So we are done with all you, I hope you all know the order, like the first derivative, that is order one. Okay, very good. And we are done with all of that. When we talk about second order linear equations, that is the most prominent among all higher order equations. When we talk of second order differential equation, we are talking about the one which is of power 2 or which is of the second degree or the second derivative. Alright, let me put it in that way. Very good. So linear equations of second order are of crucial importance in the study of differential equations for two main reasons. And what the first reason? The first reason is that linear equations have a rich theoretical structure that underlies a number of systematic method of solutions. Two, a substantial portion of this structure and this method are understandable at a fairly elementary mathematical level. So these are the two main reasons. Why a second order differential equation is most important as far as higher order differential equation is concerned. Very good. And remember, for higher order differential equation, we are not talking about only first order and the second order, we also have third order and the rest. Very good. Another reason to study second order linear differential equation is that they are vital to any serious investigation of the classical areas of mathematics. We can talk about the physics and others. Very good. the definition of second order linear differential equation. Let's look at the definition. So the definition Alright, so please, that is the definition. A second order differential equation is an equation involving the independent variable x. So don't forget the independent variable x and an unknown function y along with its first and second derivative value. So we are saying that a second order differential equation is an equation involving the independent variable x and an unknown function y. Not only the independent variable x and an unknown function y, but it also along with its first and second derivative. And that is the key concept. It should be involved with the first and the second derivative. It should be involved with the first and the second derivative. Alright. The first order can be left out, but if the key point or the concept is that it should involve with the second order differential equation, or it should involve with the second derivative. If let's say that we can see the first derivative in it, it doesn't mean it's not a second order. It will still be a second order. What I mean is this. Okay, we look at an example. But let me start with it. So instance, if we can have x plus y plus y prime to be equal to y prime prime. Alright. Now the independent variable here is x and the unknown function is y. This is the first derivative. This is the second derivative. So there are some cases that you will not see the first derivative in it, but rather see the second derivative and the independent variable and the unknown function. But yet, this is a second order differential equation. Alright, I hope it's clear. Very good. So, a second order ordinary differential equation is of the form that. So, this is a general view. That is the general view of the second order, standard form of the second order differential equation. Alright. So that is that. We have the first, second order, the first order, the unknown function, and it's embedded with the independent variable. Very good. Where a1 of x, and f of x are some given continuous function, on an interval I, and a2 of x cannot be equal to zero. That is another concept under second order differential equation, that the a of x can never be equal to zero. This can never be equal to zero because for it to be equal to zero, it will seem to be a second order differential equation. Because if you take this to be zero, that means that the whole of the second derivative will vanish. And when it happens like that, it will be like we are dealing with a first order differential equation. Meanwhile, we are not dealing with a first order differential equation, but we are rather dealing with what? A second order differential equation. So A1 can be equal to zero, no problem. This can be equal to zero, no problem. But the A2 of x can never be equal to zero. Alright. So that. Let's continue. Secondly, which of these is homogeneous or non-homogeneous? Because we are saying that for a second order differential equation, we can get a homogeneous
and non-homogeneous. So two still here.
Oh, so you can see that there are some of them that are equating to zero. So you can see question one, question two. These two examples is not equating to zero. So we can say this is non-homogeneous. Non-homogeneous. How is clear? So this is non-homogeneous differential equation. Non-homogeneous differential equation. But let's look at question 3, question 4, question 5. Question 3, question 4, question 5. These three examples is clear to us that it's forming a homogeneous differential equation. Since we are all equating to zero. So this is homogeneous differential equation. Since they are equating to zero, it is forming a homogeneous differential equation. I love this. What is left again? Another concept I introduced to you is that we have the case whereby it is a second order differential equation, alright, but it is with whether constant coefficient or variable coefficient. Very good. So let's look at it and see. The first one, the coefficient, don't forget, we focus our concept on the coefficient for the y prime and the coefficient for the y. Okay? Very good. So looking at the first question, the coefficient for the y prime, but first of all, make sure that the second derivative, the coefficient is 1. Make sure that the second derivative, the coefficient is 1. Alright. So here, the coefficient is 1, so the focus is not there. Now, there is no unknown value in it. So the P of X is not a focus. So let's look at the P of X. Oh, so the P of X is 2X. Is 2X. And 2X is not a constant, but it's rather a variable coefficient. So this is a variable coefficient, but not a constant coefficient. So this is a variable coefficient. So let's see the one which is forming a variable coefficient. So question one is from a variable coefficient. Let's go to question 2. The coefficient here is 1, correct? Let's move on. P of S, P of S. Oh! This is a constant 6. This is a constant 9. Therefore, this is, and I thought you told me, constant coefficient. So this is second derivative with a constant coefficient. Alright, so how is it? Yeah, question 2 is constant coefficient because these are constants. Ha, I love this. Question 3. Okay, this is 1, so no problem there. If that is the reaction to be S, you need to divide this N throughout. That is where the concept is coming from. Alright, so here supposed to be 1. And now it's 1. So let's focus on the coefficient for the y prime and the y. Here is x and here is 3. So this is forming a variable coefficient. So question 3 is variable coefficient. Alright, I love these tabs. Let's move on. Oh, coefficient is 1. Oh, yeah, coefficient is negative 1, not 1, negative 1. Yeah, coefficient is negative 4. Oh, so this is a constant coefficient. Question 4. Constant coefficient. Last one. Two constant. Here is one established. The concept is established. Here is negative one. It's a constant. Negative two. It's a constant. Wow. Please, we have made a mistake and we need to correct it. I'll talk about this. But for now, let me tell you that this is not in the standard form. The whole of this is in the standard form of y prime prime plus p of x y prime plus p of x y is equal to 0. Sorry, it's equal to f of x. You can see from here that right after the constant term, right after the unknown function 1, the equal to sign will come. Then next, after the equal sign, is the constant term. Oh, but in the case that after the y, watch, after the y, we need to send it to this side in order for us to know where this is going to fall. Even though it's a second order differential equation, but we need to do something about it. So let's do that. Y prime prime minus y prime minus 6y equal to negative x. This is how we leave it. This is the standard form. This is the standard form. Please help your watching. This is the standard form. So this question 5 is not a homogeneous differential equation. Don't be confused. It's not a homogeneous differential equation. When you leave it in a standard form, you will see that it is not equating to 0. We have the constant term here. So we need to send it to the other side. So it fails to be at the homogeneous, but it's rather non-homogeneous. Hope it's clear. Very good. Therefore, let's check if it's going to fall under the variable coefficient or the constant coefficient. So let's see. Here is one is established. Oh, so you can see this is constant coefficient. So this will fall under constant coefficient. Is that what you're confused? But I always make sure that you are in the standard form. Alright. In fact, there are some cases. These are the basic concepts, okay? There are some cases that you can get it like this. And you'll be thinking that, oh, it's true, it's a second order differential equation, alright. Because of the second derivative. But to check whether it's homogeneous or no homogeneous, you can say that it is no homogeneous because the constant term is there, so it is no homogeneous, alright. But for you to judge by whether it's variable coefficient or constant coefficient, you need to critical look at something, because here the standard form of the coefficient here is 1. So we need to divide both sides by, we need to divide x throughout. So x y prime prime over x plus 2 x y prime over x plus x y over x equals e raised to x over x, and let's cancel this y prime prime plus 2 y prime, because this will cancel this. Plus, this will cancel this. Y becomes e raised to x over x. So now, you can see that this is a constant coefficient. In fact, Hope the understanding is clear. And I entreat you all to continue to solve more questions. Alright. So, thing that you can try on this to justify it in any of the concept intros. And that is so first of all, is this second order differential equation? If yes, is it non-homogeneous differential equation? If yes, is it homogeneous differential equation? If yes, is it common parameter coefficient or constant coefficient? So that's that, and see you in the next video. Alright, so in the next video, we are just going to do something small. We are going to look at. In the next video, we are going to look at the general theory of nth order linear equations. The general theory of nth order linear equation. Alright, so I think that is all that I have for you in this video. Alright. Thank you. Alright. Please, if you haven't subscribed, make sure you go to YouTube. Search Math Expert and subscribe. Math Expert. Whether you add estimates or you ignore, it will happen. Alright, thank you.